Hello, beautiful Aquariuses, and welcome to your mid-monthly reading for the month of October. If this is your first time here, my name is Laura, and I am from babycurltarot.com. I am a tarot and oracle reader, as well as a root worker. Please keep in mind, Aquariuses, this is a general collective reading, so not all messages will resonate for every single Aquarius out there. If for some reason these messages don't resonate, but you would like more clarification on anything that you're currently experiencing at this point in time, I do offer personal one-on-one readings, and you can link up with me through my website, which is below in the description box. With all that in mind, let's go ahead and jump right into your reading, starting off with the tea leaf fortune cards to see what possible situations or energies may be popping up for you for the rest of the month. Spirit, what messages do you have for my Aquariuses? That was fast. Let's take a look here. Oh, we got three. Okay. I'm gonna have to reshuffle. I'm looking for two cards and two cards only. Spirit, what messages do you have for my Aquariuses for the rest of October? Okay, we got one. Yep, just one. Any additional messages? Okay, let's check the other half of the deck. Spirit, any messages for my Aquariuses for the rest of October? Okay, that's too many. Spirit, any messages? Okay. I've got a lot to say for you guys. Let's see here. Spirit, any messages? Okay, I think I saw one flip over. Yes, there we go. All right, come here. All right, Aquariuses, we got our cards. Let's take a look. So the first one was the broken wishbone. Wish will not be granted. All right. And then we have key, successful outcome to your problems. All right. I'm already getting a message. It feels like something you really want is not necessarily meant for you with this broken wishbone, and you probably won't see it happen. But it feels like there's something else better that Spirit wants to direct you to in order for you to get what you really, really want, okay? Like your ultimate goal. So let's take a look. Let's start clarifying. Starting with the broken wishbone, a wish will not be granted. I am clarifying with the Sugar Skull Tarot deck for the rest of the month. Let's go ahead and take a look. Spirit, what messages do you have for my Aquariuses regarding this broken wishbone? What messages do you have for my Aquariuses regarding this broken wishbone? Okay, we have the Knight of Swords reversed, Four of Wands reversed, and the Two of Swords. At the bottom of the deck, we have the Magician. Okay. Let's go ahead and take a look at your cards. Again, I'm already starting to kind of see where this is going. Okay, so with the Magician, we have Virgo and Gemini energy. With the Two of Swords, we have Libra. Four of Wands is Aries, and the Knight of Swords is Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. All right, Aquariuses. So what I'm seeing is, particularly with the Magician card here, you guys have definitely been trying to manifest something. And I'm not surprised it's here, granted that this is a wish type message, because the Magician definitely is the card where someone is able to make their manifestations or their dreams happen. Okay. What I am seeing, though, is that while you are definitely blessed and capable of making things happen in your life, it feels like Spirit is definitely trying to redirect you, because there is a different path that they want you to see outside of the one you think is best for you. Okay, and that definitely came through at the beginning of the video. Like I said, it feels like they're kind of trying to redirect you into a better situation or a better option for where it is that you're trying to go. Okay, so don't be surprised if when whatever it is that this wish is falls through, don't be surprised if you find something else completely more aligned with what it is that you're actually trying to achieve here. All right, but it definitely feels like whatever it is that you're wishing for, it doesn't have strong foundations enough for you to really get everything that you want out of it, which is why, again, Spirit's trying to redirect you here. So the Knight of Swords reversed definitely feels like you probably will be getting a message regarding, you know, that whatever it is that you've been trying to achieve isn't going to happen for you. So just be aware, it may take a little bit longer than expected, which is okay, but Just keep in mind again that there is definitely something else better out there for you. I'm definitely strongly feeling that. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at the Numinous Astro deck and see where this could be happening for you astrologically speaking. Spirit, what messages do you have for my Aquariuses regarding this broken wishbone? All right, we have Libra. Very interesting. Some of you, this may be happening in the seventh house, but I would definitely check to see where Libra falls in your chart, what planets are in Libra, which house is in Libra. Oh, but look at this. We have the fifth house at the bottom of the deck. This is the fifth house of passion, performance, entertainment, creativity, play, love affairs, passion, pleasure, parties, children, humor, romance, and disco ball. So for some of you, this could be romance related. This could be entertainment related as well. Maybe you guys work in the entertainment industry. Okay. So for some of you, this is very much strongly, I think, love related. That kind of came up earlier as I was looking at the cards, like this might be love related. But yeah, take what resonates. Definitely check out and see where Libra is in your chart. Check out what's going on in your fifth house, what planets are in the fifth house for you, and where the fifth house falls in terms of zodiac signs. That can definitely help you understand what it is that may be happening for you on a personal level. Let's go ahead and take a look at the Moonology Oracle deck and get some final advice or messages for you regarding this wishbone. Spirit, what messages do you have for my Aquariuses regarding this broken wishbone? Let's take a look. The answers you need are coming. Full moon in Gemini. Yeah. Definitely feel that. And I feel like it's going to be coming through with this key. All right. We also have the end of a tough cycle approaches. Full moon in Capricorn. Okay. Some of you guys may have been... Some of you guys may have been trying to get out of a situationship and make a connection a little bit more solidified, possibly in terms of like an exclusive relationship, whatever the case may be. Some of you guys may have been performing part-time for a certain company. If you guys work in the entertainment industry, like I said, you may have confronted this person or company and said, hey, you know, what's going on here? What are we doing? That old conversation, you know. So this person's probably like, well, I need time to think about it. You know, let me just think about it a little bit. And I feel like you guys definitely will be receiving an answer. So just be prepared that it probably won't be the answer you're hoping for. However, I am excited to see what this key says to see what possibly may be coming up for you around the corner. So let's go ahead and clear the table and move on to this key. All right, the key, successful outcome to your problems. Give it to us, Spirit. What's going on here? Let's just shuffle up the tarot deck really quick. Shuffle. All right, Spirit, what messages do you have for my Aquariuses regarding this key? What message do you have for my Aquariuses regarding this key? Ten of Pentacles, Seven of Wands reversed, and the Star card. I mean, come through. Good energy. Queen of Wands at the bottom of the deck. I love it. Let's go ahead and take a look at these cards, and I'll get into the message for you here. All right, so Queen of Wands at the bottom of the deck is Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy. We have Aquarius here with the Star card. Honey, that's you for sure. Seven of Wands reversed is going to be Leo energy, and then Ten of Pentacles is Virgo. All right, Aquariuses, you couldn't ask for two better cards than the Ten of Pentacles and the Star to show up with this key. Like I said, it feels like this wish was not going to take you to this energy right here. The Ten of Pentacles talks about literally everything we have worked for, culminating into security, stability, whether that's financially, health-wise, family-wise, okay? I mean, it's literally everything we dream of and work for to have that beautiful, perfect ending to our story, okay? Let's put it that way. The star card here, definitely represented by Aquarius. This is just the shine that you have been waiting for, the recognition, the love, the opportunities that you've been working for, everything you have dreamed of literally coming true. It's a wish fulfillment. Literally everything you could want is right here with this key. So don't be so hung up on the fact that this wish didn't get granted, because it feels like there's something way, way better around the corner. This Queen of Wands energy is really, really interesting. I don't know if this is maybe someone you know, or someone you may run into who recognizes star quality in you. Again, if you work in the entertainment industry, this could be someone already very well off or prominent in the field of whatever it is that you do, and they recognize that you're talented, that you have potential, and they want to offer you an opportunity to kind of move in that lane. Possibly, and I don't know, normally associate mentorship with the Queen of Wands, but this person could very well end up being a mentor and kind of helping you, move into some, spaces that can get you noticed and recognized. This person could say, hey, have you tried doing this? Have you tried going here? Have you tried reaching out to this person? They could be the connection that kind of gets you to where you want to be. For others of you, if this is love related, this is definitely a really enigmatic, charismatic, gorgeous, fiery, confident, beautiful young thing coming through for you guys. And just kind of lighting your world up again. And this person just is full of energy and love and passion and adventure. And it's just, everything you guys could possibly wish for, which is absolutely beautiful. Again, I don't feel like you guys are gonna see this coming. It's gonna be really expected here with the Seven of Wands reverse. It's really gonna sweep you off your feet. You're not gonna know what hits you. But a beautiful surprise, at least in my opinion. Let's go ahead and take a look at the Numinous Astro deck and see where, again, this could be happening for you, astrologically speaking. All right. The fourth house of roots came up. Let me just make sure nothing else flipped over. We have the fourth house of roots. Very interesting. So, excuse me, this is the house of family, home, background, comfort, cooking, inner world, real estate, shelter, self-care, rejuvenation, habits and shell. This house is ruled by Cancer normally. Definitely take a look and see what planets and which zodiac sign rules your fourth house. That will definitely help figure out what possibly could be happening here for you. We also have Pluto at the bottom of the deck, the planet of transformation, renewal, inner resources, basic instinct, motivation, personal power, evolution, cycles of death and rebirth, intensity, taboos, clearing, and extremes. It definitely feels like you're being kind of revived from whatever energy this was with Pluto. That's for sure. It's like, all right, we're ending one part of the journey and we're pushing ourselves and being reborn in another part. It definitely feels like you guys have been revived here, at least with this key. Again, I'm not quite sure where this may be happening for you. Just take what resonates. If it's resonating in one thing, then that's probably what's working for you here. What's really kind of stumping me is this fourth house, because the fourth house is all about home, comfort. This may be bringing you some really strong stability, definitely here with the Ten of Pentacles. Maybe you guys have Virgo in the fourth house. I would be interested to see if that resonates for you guys or any of you. But definitely a lot of stability here with the Ten of Pentacles. So it's possible that this could be an opportunity for you to move as well, an opportunity for you to have stable housing or to move to a place that possibly you've always wanted to, maybe an opportunity to work closer to home. Okay, for some of you guys may have been traveling really, really, really long distances in order to make things work here. You may have something that's a little bit closer to home, makes you feel a little bit more comfortable, a little bit more stable. Definitely something to look into. Let's go ahead and take a look at the Moonology Oracle and see what final messages and advice Spirit has for you. All right. Spirit, what final messages or advice do you have for my Aquariuses regarding this key? Any final messages or advice? Adjustments are required. Third quarter moon. Okay. Okay. Adjustments are required for some of you. You guys may indeed be moving. Adjustments are required. Definitely going to have to move for some of you. Going to have to possibly step up your game a little bit. Learn how to interact with certain people a little bit differently. The end of a tough cycle approaches. Full moon in Capricorn at the bottom of the deck. Look at that. It's going to be a lot of changes, a lot of shifts here for sure. So it may, again, kind of, like I said, catch you off guard a little bit. You're going to have to probably rush around and I'm seeing someone like rushing around trying to get things in order. Okay, some of you guys said, like I said, some of you may be moving, but some of you guys are definitely trying to get certain things in order so that you're able to kind of step into this role here. All right, that sounds so exciting. I'm really excited for you guys. Please leave a like and a comment if this resonated for you. And don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. I do monthly and mid-monthly readings, as well as occasional pick-a-cards. If you would like to schedule a personal one-on-one reading with me, please link up with me through my website, which is below in the description box. And if you'd like to follow me on my other socials like Instagram and TikTok, you can find that information below as well. As always, thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys have a beautiful rest of your month, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.